Alrighty, welcome to Under Draft here on channelfireball.com. We're gonna try to avoid forcing snow, but be tempted. Not snow covered plains, though. Snow covered plains is the worst. A little Kaldheim action. Realmwalker, pretty solid start. 3-mana 2/3 changeling, and then if you ever have a bunch of creatures of the same type, this gives you some pretty good value here. There's Sculptor of Winter, but I don't like first picking Sculptor, even if I like snow. There's Blizzard Brawl, which is a good snow card as well. It is okay in non-snow as Prey Upon. But, yeah, you know, Lubras, actually, I found the Bloodline Pretender to be kind of weak. I think Bloodline Pretender is not a bad card, but it just consistently is just a Centaur Courser more than anything else. So I think I'm just going to take the Realmwalker. There's also Bounding Gold, which is a reasonable pick. I wouldn't say you're crazy for wanting to take that. Oh, sweet. We got past a Cruel Ultimatum, so that's a good sign. I love taking Cruel Ultimatum. What card is Cruel Ultimatum, you may ask? Well, I think it's obvious. Boom. Path to the World Tree. So this is a fixer, a five-color fixer that once you get to five colors also goes shock, plus they lose two, plus you draw two, plus you gain two, plus you get a bear. No, I don't do chat on screen in its arena. I don't find that to be great. Oh, I should also teleport. Right to there, so we can see all the cards I draft. There's also Doomscar Titan. Oh, and Sorrel's Packmate. I can't actually pass Sorrel's Packmate here, unfortunately, since Path of the World Tree is great, but Sorrel's Packmate is just absurd, so I got all excited. I didn't even notice there was the Packmate, which I like this as like maybe the second best common after Behold the Multiverse. Like I told Gabby on her stream, always be holding. Here we've got Skemphar Elderhall, which is a powerful land. This land can definitely turn the tide. There's Snow-Covered Plains. Again, we're seeing snowlands, but they're all the really bad ones, so I'm not that worried about it. Hey, what's up, that guy, Tomac? Welcome. There's Ravenous Lindworm, which I found to be quite strong, actually. This card is just really good in this format. Its size matches up well. Gaining four is good. There's actually like a lot of clone effects, a surprisingly large amount. And there's the 5/4, the U that goes and gets a 6-power creature. So I'm actually looking at the Lindworm, though. I think the Elder Hall is also pretty reasonable because Realmwalker does want to push us towards elves a little bit here. I think I'm just going to take the Elder Hall, actually. It's, I don't know, that one's close. Here there's no, we're going to have to branch out somewhere. There's the Knotvold Slumber Mound, which is a good red-green land. There's, hey, what's up, Hosman? Yes, I would take Behold the Multiverse over Packmate, pick one, pack one. Mm-hmm. Yeah, Hosman is one of the OGs. There's also a black-white snowland, which I'm kind of interested in. The snow duels are a lot better than the basics, and it can help maybe use this Elder Hall or something like that. The Slumber Mound is really good, but I don't love just straight red-green all that much. It's fine. There's also Master Scald, which I like to take after I have Sagas. The Sagas are all uncommons and rares, so I like this card a lot with Sagas, but I don't think you're supposed to take it before you have them. Scorned Effigy, not really much. All right, I'm just going to take the Snowfield Sinkhole, see where we end up. See where we end up. Maybe snow, maybe not, you know. Ooh, Turgrid's Shadow. So I do have the Elder Hall. Shadow could be interesting in like a black-green, more controlling deck. What else is there? There's a Grizzled Outrider, which I found to be okay, but the Worm is so much better. It's not even close. And there's Coma's Faithful, which is, again, just fine. These packs are kind of weak. I'll take the Shadow here. All right, another Packmate. Oh, that's a good sign. 6-pick Packmate. I don't know what else is open, but I know green is very likely to be wide open. My dream is that I go Realmwalker named Wolf because I have 3 or 4 Sorrel's Packmates. And here, I haven't found Raider's card to be super impressive. There's also Carful Kennelmaster, which I do like as a card, but I like this a lot more in black-white or red-white, or sorry, red-black, which tend to be a little more aggressive than black-green. The Knotvold Recluse sucks. The Skullcairn, really not that like, it's okay, but it's not that powerful of a land here. Someone is taking some snowlands for sure. So when it comes to Packmate versus Behold, it's more to text than the colors because I think blue and green are both solid. I think I might just take the Kennelmaster because it's the best card in our colors, even though I don't Yeah, I mean, I don't love it. There's also a replicating ring. So someone's taking snow to the degree that I don't feel like I'm likely to end up in snow at this point. Why is Turgrid's Shadow good? Because you can set it up nicely and get a pretty big advantage. When this works, it's a 2-for-1. But not even just a 2-for-1, it can kill two really good things if you can like foretell this, play like some like a acceleration or card draw spell, then they play their second creature and you flip it over. I think I'm just going to take the second Kennel Master here over Replicating Ring. Replicating Ring is a nice snow card, but snow just doesn't seem like it's open right now. I guess I could take Snow Covered Plains because I'm not going to play Scorn Effigy outside the double spells deck, and I'm not at this point. I don't really see me getting into like a Warhorn Blast or one of these like medium red cards. So let's just do that. No reason not to. Wither Crown is fine. It's not good. Oh, there's also Raven Wings. Actually, I think I want Raven Wings here. I like Raven Wings if I end up being a kind of like green-black aggressive deck. Like the Shadow's not looking that very good there. But if you go like play some creatures, Kennel Master hit, next turn wings up the Kennel Master. Yeah, I'm into that. Hey, what's up, Vader? Yeah, there's Broken Wings, which I like in a more controlling deck. It's a card I'm probably like 30% to main deck, 70% not. Obviously, we're playing best of one, so I don't need a sideboard card. And then there's Snakeskin Veil in order to protect our stuff. I think I'm slightly... I don't have any interaction. I guess I'll take the Broken Wings. No, Squirrel. You know what? There's actually plenty of Bagel Ice Cream left, as it turns out. All right, I'll take the Slumber Bound over nothing. I mean, it's a powerful card. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so we got some everything. Me and Gabby, we... Definitely wasn't just me ordering it. Got some everything Bagel Ice Cream from Jenny's. And it's like cream cheese ice cream, sweet cream cheese ice cream with... You know, with like bagel streusel, so it sounds pretty good. It also has the onions and garlic that you expect on an everything bagel, which you're... It sounded interesting, sounded cool. I would say a little goes a long way is my my evaluation of such. Yeah. All right, what do we got here? There's Redain, God of the Worthy. I do have the black-white Snowland. Redain is very strong, mostly for Valkmira Protector Shield. You play the Protector Shield, all your stuff takes one less damage, and so do you, and then everything costs one more to target. Well, there's Guardian Gladewalker. I'm not going to first pick Gladewalker, it's too weak. There's, as a white splash, there's Shepherd of the Cosmos, but I don't really even have anything that's good to get back with it. There's also another green-white land. I think I might just take Redain here. There's also Skemphar Shadow Mage. Though Skinfar Shadow Mage actually could be pretty good if I end up in Elves. All right, now the double Kennel Master makes me not want to splash as much. All right, I'll probably just take Vengeful Reaper here. It's a shame I don't like passing Spirit of the Elder Guard. I do like Spirit quite a bit, but Vengeful Reaper is very strong. Just 2/3 Flying Haste, Death Touch. You can also cast it on the cheap. So I think green was open pack one. I don't know if black was open. People haven't really been respecting the Kennel Master. Turgrid's Shadow not looking great here. But I think I like the colors we're in, even if, I don't know, that pack one was just kind of weak on average besides the late pack mate here. Pack one was Realm Walker, which is part of why I took the Shadow Sage. I do think that if I end up black-green, Shadow Sage and Realm Walker will both be pretty strong here. Raise the Draugr. But you can usually get one of those. I don't really need the duel. I might just take a second Elder Hall. There's also Glade Warden. These are both decent. Elder Hall is really strong just because lands that do things are quite good. And second Elder Hall with the Shadow Sage means I can end up with a lot of elves in play here. Okay. Although we have a prediction going. How many scoops of the Everything Bagel ice cream did I have? Well, I'll let you all guess here. Yeah, Glade Warden's also pretty slow. There's also Elven Bow is nice here. Makes a little 2/3 reach elf and can help grind them out. There's also Elderfang Disciple, which is solid. And Grimdraugr and Rhymewood Falls, not really interested in those right now. Always be holding. Some good cards here. Whoever cut snow in pack one might be getting paid off now. One reason to take Elderfang is upping the count for Realmwalker. But I found the bow to be strong enough that I'd rather just have the bow here. They're just all quite good. See, look, now I can choose between one of three elves. Guardian Gladewalker, Masked Vandal, or Elderfang. Probably just going to go with the Masked Vandal. It this effect has been really good. Being able to blow up an artifact or enchantment pretty reliably while being all colors is nice. So let's take the Masked Vandal here. Is the worst gross ice cream? The Everything Bagel ice cream was ooh, it was interesting. Here we could go with third Kennel Master or a Blizzard Brawl. So how's Blizzard Brawl looking? Well, I don't have any snowlands. It's good enough with Elven Bow. I think I'm going to have as many Kennel Masters as I want, so I'd rather just take the Brawl. Plus, there's a chance I pick up some snow permanence. This doesn't require snow lands, so creatures also work out nicely. Mm-hmm. Keep in mind when you're betting here that Jenny's Ice Cream is very good. It's like one of the best ice cream brands you can get. But, now that the predictions are closed, I'll reveal that I, in fact, had less than one scoop of it because a little goes a long way is a way to put it. I don't know. It wasn't doing it for me. I might try again at some point, but yeah, no. There's a Raise the Draugr here. I might raise a glass to freedom here. This is just not turning into not a Turgrid's Shadow deck. Though Elven Bow, I mean, Turgrid's Shadow is kind of nice with the Skemphar Elder Hall. I'll take Raise the Draugr. If I end up pretty heavy elves, which I would like to now, look, I can pick up a nice Grizzle Outrider. Nice little elf here. If I end up with like 10 elves in my deck, which I would like to with this Realm Walker, then the Raise the Draugr is gonna be a strong one. Alright, now I'll pick the Guardian Glade Walker. This is about where I'd want to pick it. And another Grizzled Outrider. Alright. Well, I'm glad I didn't take the other Kennel Master. I've got enough high end here. I'll take Duskwielder here. It's actually good with Raven Wings, and I already have a Raven Wings. Didn't wheel anything I wanted. Raider's Carve might not be crazy in this deck. I have a lot of high-powered creatures. All right. I'll take another Glade Walker. I don't think... I'm not going to regret passing on Wither Crown here. I don't know if I'm allowed to say whether or not I'm covering the next two mocks, but I do like covering Cube Draft. So, who knows what that could mean. So many shadows, casting a long shadow here. Another Blizzard Brawl here. Icebreaker Kraken, I love it. Not for this deck, though. Also, Icebreaker Kraken's not actually good. It's just really hard to get there. So what am I going to take here? Horizon Seeker is like not an elf, kind of medium. Because you just like, I don't know, you play this, you can go get a land, but I'm not splashing, so it's not there. Yeah, there's some good snow cards here. Funeral Longboat's awful. I think this card's really bad. I think that the Carve might make it in because that at least gives you some upside when it works. I think I might just take another Blizzard Brawl, even though I hate having a bunch of fight cards in my deck. All right, now there's the Lindworm, but I have a lot of high end. I think I'm just going to take Elderfang Disciple here and maybe try to wheel Skull Raid, have a little bit of a discard element. So now there's another Lindworm. The question is, do I want Snow Covered Forest? So the reason to take Snow Covered Forest is if I get to three snow permanents, Blizzard Brawls really pop off. There's no other snow permanents I have right now, so I don't know how likely that is. But I don't really need the Lindworm is the thing. Yeah, I don't think this is an Infernal Pet deck so much. All right, I'm just going to take the Snowland because I just don't think either of those cards really do much for me. All right, I'm actually happy enough taking another Elderfang Disciple. Yes, Demonic Gift might wheel and I might actually play it. Koma's Faithful is just okay. Jarl the Forsaken actually isn't bad because you hit up with a lot of dorky little creatures, but I think I like Elderfang, especially since I have a couple ways to recur it. So Death Knell Berserker is looking okay here because I've got Elven Bow and Raven Wings to buff it up here. Yeah, plus two Guardian Glade Walkers. Yeah, that's totally enough. It's funny, I was making fun of Ben. I was watching Ben stream earlier and making fun of him for drafting green black, which, I mean, sometimes you just draft what you draft, like he said. But yes, I haven't been impressed with this deck so much. We'll see if this deck performs. See, part of it is like, look, you just cast this Elderleaf Mentor and it's fine. But it just gets bricked by so much, you know? Like, I am going to take it. I don't really have any good Elves payoffs besides the Realmwalker and I guess the Shadow Sage. It would be nice to pick up a late, like, Herald Champions the Elves or whatever it is. I'll take Dread Rider, but I really can't anticipate playing that. Rune of Mortality is not terrible on just like a random dork. I really don't think I'm going to play Infernal Pet here. I guess I have a decent amount of cheap stuff. I'd rather just take the rune, I think. Rune on the bow. Yeah, that can grind him out. That definitely can. Oh, I should update. Hold on. So let me update my decks. Draugr Recruiter, but not going to play it here. I'll have to update it after the draft, actually. I don't know what channel points I'm going to add. Oh, a Lindworm Wheel. All right. I might play a Lindworm. Who knows? The Snow-Covered Forest pick didn't really work out, but I didn't really lose much out of it. All right. I'll play Demonic Gifts and Coma's Faithful, sure. Is the Recruiter not good? Which one's the Recruiter? All right. Oh, the Bow Zombie? No, this card is just really expensive. I have not thought it's good. So I ended up with not enough snow permanents to play the snow card. There's Snow Way. Or rather, not enough snow permanents to justify playing a tapped Snowland. I could play the forest, but I don't think I'm going to. Five Clarion Spirits? Oh, that's a lot of Clarion Spirits. So I probably want to cut a Kennel Master here. Well, the question is, do I want Kennel Master or Worm? Actually, I'm going to cut the Worm. I think I'm more likely to want the Kennel Master as my high end. I do like the... I actually think Demonic Gift's fine here. It's pretty nice on Deathnail Berserker. It's pretty nice on Elderfang Disciple. And it's okay on like Skemphar Shadow Sage or Cerule's Packmate. This is surprisingly good. Maybe I'll just cut one of the Blizzard Brawls. I mean, I have the two Packmates and I have like six big creatures. It's just so bad with these like creatures that just die when you use it, you know. I don't think I want Turgrid's Shadow. I think Turgrid's Shadow is not where I want to be. The question is, do I want to cut Duskwielder here? What's it good with? It's basically just go to the Raven Wings. Hey, what's up, Money? I don't think I want 16 land because I have two equipment and I have two Skemphar Elder Halls, which make me not mind playing a decent amount of lands here. All right, yeah, this is a solid little deck. Not bad. It could have used like another Elf Payoff or two. I think it's a little bit short on that. This works good. This works. I think it's fine, Tom. It has a couple, like the, I think the equipment is going to be surprisingly good at grinding people out. Like the Realmwaker plus the Raise the Draugr plus the two equipment, I think is decent. Hey, what's up, Newmont? Welcome everyone from Newmont's stream. Let's suspend the Reaver here. Yeah. I mean, I don't like Elves very much. Like, I don't like being in this deck. It also has two Cerule's Packmates, so it's like doing all right on card advantage. This card's pretty hard to beat. If I had the Blizzard Brawl here, it actually would work out. Because next turn they're going to exile this, and it's just going to be. Oh yeah, I need to move. Sorry. Next turn they're going to exile that, and that's going to be it. All right, so. Here, I think I just play Coma's Faithful rather than the Reaper. Yeah, Kosiva God of the Voyage is a nice one. Is black as bad as people are making it out to be? I don't know how people are making it out to be, but I think black is likely the worst color, yeah. So basically, for me to win this, I'm going to have to, like, beat through a Cosima. That's going to be tough. Hey, what's up, Corey? Welcome back. 2 years. Corey, 15, 98. Well, replicating ring. Okay. So they're going to not attack with the hawk here. All right. I am going to attack. I'm hoping to... I guess I actually should have played the Reaper because I'm most likely to play Masked Vandal here now that I think about it. But I can also play Raise the Drugger. Let's blow up the replicating ring. And... what are we going to blow up here? Zombie, Berserker, Wolf, Cleric. So none of these are duplicates. I think I'm least likely to want the Kennel Master and the... yeah, so I should have definitely played this first, but I actually still think it's better to play it here. Because I'm not going to cast the Raise the Drugger this turn. But yeah, definitely wanted to slam with Vengeful Reaper. We'll see how this ends up going. If they have a, if they run out of lands, this could be good for me. But if they don't, it's going to be tough. Agar the Freezing Flame. Oh, they don't have a land. Okay. Interesting. I guess I'll just hit with the Reaper and play the Shadow Sage, Angel Cleric. So I name Cleric and drain them for three. So they have Frostbite in hand, I suppose. Definitely nugging them. And then I'll play this. And so this is six mana total, so I can't quite use that yet. So, all right, their Cosima is going to get another counter, unless they want to bring Cosima back here. Do I have a favorite archetype? I like drafting five-color snow. How did it end up in green-black? This is just what was open. There wasn't... weren't really very many exit opportunities otherwise. Started in green with actually a good Elves card, picked up two Sorulf's Packmates, and then started picking up black cards. Like a reason, like fifth pick, Vengeful Reaper, that sort of thing. Craven Hulk. Okay. So they're still on two snow, so they can't quite kill the Vengeful Reaper. I guess I'll hit with the Reaper. When I say five color snow, I mean anywhere between two and five colors. Like it's not, it's most common, like some Sultai base splashing a red card or two. Sometimes you splash white bombs, who knows. I guess I'll just play the Grizzled Outrider rather than playing the Sorulf's Packmate here. I've done a good job not playing anything into Frostbite. If they draw a snow covered land here, it's going to be pretty rough. Raven Wings is really good. All right, so at this point, yeah, they're going to bring Cosima back. All right, this is actually quite beatable. If they had a steady stream of lands and could slow roll this till it got like three or four counters, it'd be a lot harder. But as is, yeah, they played a 4/6 that drew them two cards, which is good, but it's not unbeatable. Yes, if I draw Raven Wings, oof, we're getting in there. It's not as much that white doesn't have snow cards. That's definitely a part of it. It's just that you play white when you splash like a bomb, like Redain, God of Justice, or something like that. Are they going to double Frostbite it? Or they thought they had three snow? I'll take it. That works for me. I guess my bear can't attack. Let's just play a Sorulf's Packmate here. Oh, it did not tap me very well. Okay. Well, that's fine, I guess. Frostbite only sees lands, yeah. Oh no, sorry, this sees all permanents. But they thought this was snow, maybe, is the thing. They can re-exile Cosima, but it's gonna be tough because I do have a Grizzle Outrider. If they remove a 4/6 from the board, it might be hard for them. Yeah, I might just equip the bow on the flyer and start cracking in for more here. That might be the plan. They target me because they want to stop me from drawing good cards. That's pretty reasonable. I could also start using these Elder Halls. The Elder Hall's pretty expensive. We're at 11. Yeah, I think I'm going to do that. I'm going to nug the Draugr Thought Thief here. Because this just puts them in a position where I might be able to like swarm them, especially if I can get back Skimfar Shadow Mage. I'm actually going to go and just play the Elven Bow because I'm not going to make a token here. So I might as well just get it out. Yeah, Carrie, that seems like a pretty good strategy. The five-color snow deck with the World Tree. Seize the spoils. Get another Craven Hulk into the graveyard. All right, all right. The giveaway is random draw from everyone. So they did find the squash to kill my Valkyrie, which is unfortunate. It's Angel Cleric, Wolf, Elf Cleric. I mean, I could get back Koma's Faithful and the Angel. I mean, I do kind of want to get back the Skimfar Shadow Mage at some point, but I just don't really have good attacks here because they can double block like this, and then the Grizzled Outrider draws them a card. I guess if I attack with Outrider, let's see, what do? They can double block with Craven Hulk and Kinseekers, and so I'm just trading for a Craven Hulk. What if I put the bow on this? 6-7. They have to double block. It doesn't change that much. It's tough. Because like they're not close to being able to attack me, and I guess they have an Agar. At some point they could also exile Cosima. I think I'm just gonna get back these two. Because the Vengeful Reaper, like, yeah, Skimfar Shadow Mage might start dealing them damage at some point. But the Vengeful Reaper will start dealing damage now. So this seems like it's a good amount of pressure. And now they can't really afford to exile Cosima, I don't think. Too long-term plan. So Beers, you're asking about what I think about the design, because there's the, like, some of the snow cards check on land, some check on permanents, some of the activated lands like Elder Horror Sorcery, some just put creatures in tap but are instant. Yeah, I think that there's enough. It's too complicated, I believe, and there's not enough through lines which are help you predict where something's going to be. So a lot of the mistakes people are going to make in the set are assuming something works a certain way because other cards like it work a certain way. Boom. All right. Silver for now. All right. I'm going to give away one of the box break slots soon here. Let's maybe once I hit three wins. I'm on the play. All right. Demonic Gifts looking kind of nice here. Blizzard Brawl's looking kind of terrible. I'm playing best of one to rank up and just play against different decks. And I have a best of three deck I don't want to play because I'm making a video with it. So all of those combined. Best of one's fine too. I don't think the difference is huge and limited. I prefer best of three by a little, but I don't think it's all terrible. Let's go Elder Fang. Let's just play your card. Can you trade out box break giveaways for store credit? I'm not sure. There might be an option to do that, but I'm not 100% sure. All right, take one. Play Elderleaf Mentor here. Kennel Master is looking pretty good here. I mean, and I might be able to set up a turn with like Demonic Brawl plus, or sorry, Demonic Gifts plus Blizzard Brawl. I mean, who knows? I think the design could have been more disciplined, yes. So with Elderfang Disciple, oh man, another. Agar is just really good. I don't think I had an attack in Demonic Gift there. I guess I could have probably attacked because they would have worried about Jarl of the Forsaken, but saving Elderfang until later is definitely fine. In this case, because I had like just a curve, I just wanted to play my creatures out. Svella Ice Shaper. Okay. And then green on a Shimmer Drift Veil. Ooh, these lands coming into play not untapped are kind of brutal. Let's see. So what happens if I attack with like everything? If they block the 2/1s, Demonic Gift there. I actually think it's fine. Okay, let's just Demonic Gifts the Elderleaf Mentor. That works for me. Yunk, and play an Elder Hall. And then next turn, if I draw a land, I can set up Brawl plus Kennel Master. Actually, having double Kennel Master makes me wonder if I should be playing the second Brawl as well. This is a really good combo on six, because you just get to get something indestructible and then battle with it. The timing on this is weird on the Shimmer Drift, where it's like, they just say something and then it comes into play. Hey, Surreal Sea Dragon, 6-month resub. Oh, and they're tapping out to Foretell. I didn't draw a land, unfortunately. So Kennel Master pushes through not that much damage, but I think I should just play it anyway. Yeah. Actually, I'm just going to Kennel Master those two. Attack like this, and if they want to trade Agar for Elderleaf Mentor and draw a card, they can do that. Okay. Oh, this still draws a card? Huh. All right, that's fair. So maybe I should have just put it on the Mentor and attack for four. I guess I didn't really think about the indestructible thing with Agar. Good to know. Our D&D party fought us a little sea dragon, not a big one, a young one. If you have to, for the giveaway, you're going to have to enter it. It's not just automatic if you're in chat. Bum, bum, bum. Had a pretty cool battle in D&D yesterday, though. That was fun. Mm-hmm. And then Demon Bolting my Elderleaf Mentor because they wanted the card instead of the Kennel Master. I gotcha. Shh, shh, shh. Yeah, like I said, now. Oh, they're going to get to tap my Kennel Master. So let's just go to combat here. No attacks. Elder Fang Disciple. And then Coma's Faithful here. Pass. Crush the Weak would be. That would be bad for me. They would draw 5 cards. What's playing through my headphones? Nothing right now. Oh, you'll be able to enter the giveaway as soon as I run it. You just have to type in whatever it is, the thing I say. Easy. Mm-hmm. Okay, so they're going to make a Sculptor of Winter. Interesting. Usually being stuck on 5 lands would be pretty good, but it's actually like not working out exactly how I want here. Let's go. I could Blizzard Brawl the Kennel Master and Agar to start with, and then play a bow and equip on the Coma's Faithful and start attacking with that. I could also play a Kennel Master on these two. They tap Kennel Master and attack with Coma's Faithful for 4. Then I have double Kennel Master in play. Kind of like that, I think. Like, at this point, you know, the pillar is going to make it tough for me to get in there anyway. It's always going to stop the Kennel Master activation. So I think this works out all right. Yeah, giveaways for anywhere that CFB ships to, which is largely worldwide. But we'll see when you get there. Let's see if they tap here. Bum, bum, bum. They're going to tap the Kennel Master, and then I'll attack with Coma's Faithful. And they could chump with Agar and draw a card, I guess. But yeah, they're just going to take it. I'm also setting up being able to use Elder Hall, like post-combat Elder Hall if they block 4/4 on a 3/1 or something like that. Koiten Batsu, welcome back to the 2-month Harisub Arena. It's not sealed product, Yusha. The box breaks don't work that way. Oh, well, they have the pillar, but Ravenwings got me excited for a second there. All right, let's go. Blizzard Brawl, Kennel Master and Agar to start things out. What I could also do with Raven Wings is just like put it on like an elf token, and then, or an Elder Fang, and then if they want to tap down the Elder Fang, that's going to be not so great for them. The problem is I don't really have good attacks into these things. Let's just go wings. I'll wait on the bow. Wings on Elder Fang Disciple and see what they say. Where do you have Run Amok in the format? It depends on your deck. It's really good in aggro decks. It's not really playable outside of aggro decks. All right, I'll just crash in for two then. Works for me. I think I kind of said this in the set reviews. Like, it's one of the best giant growths you can have for aggro decks. Now I'm just going to attack and use the Elder Hall after they block here. No, Calvin Dog, I like it here. Yeah, all you have to do to enter is just hang out and chat, and when I announce the giveaway, you'll just have to type in whatever the giveaway phrase is, and you can get there. Yeah, like here, even if so, like, I guess they're not gonna necessarily die, but I might post combat just use Elder Hall to finish off like their 3/5, for example, or maybe their 4/4. I don't know. They have to have something I guess they don't have to. Sorry, this has got tapped. Hey, M. Collins, welcome back. So now, Elder Hall, the Kinseekers here. And part of what's strong about Elder Hall is it also just puts two elves into play. Like, now they have to have a sweeper or they're really dead here. Kaya's Onslaught plus Run Amok is, of course, fantastic. I don't get the people who say good game then keep playing. Like, I get what they're saying is like, oh, you're probably going to win, but like, I just say good game when I concede, if I feel like saying it. I mean, when it's online, I don't think it's rude not to. You don't have to emote to your opponent if you don't want. But it'd be weird. Like, imagine playing Paper Magic, someone says good game, and you're like, all right, good game. And then they just sit there, and you play for two more turns or whatever. When should you say bad game? Hey, what's up, Zeno? Welcome back to the 813 sub. Yeah, it's just weird to me. I don't know. Like, you can do whatever. I don't really care. But... it's just kind of bizarre. Well, Raven Wings didn't really get there. It was mostly me grinding them out. But Raven Wings would have been fairly strong if they didn't have the Icebind Pillar. I almost wish I'd just taken the second one here. But I had the Elven Bow also. Yeah, exactly, Rebecca. Like, they're like, good game. And you're like, am I dead? Or what do you mean here? Like, what's going on? In paper, I tend to say good game after I lose. And offer a handshake and that's it. If I win, I tend not to, but you know, I don't think it's a big deal either way. This is like the dorky mid-range common curve. Like, look at me. I've got 2-drop, 3-drop, 5-drop, 5-drop of not premium commons, but not the worst commons either. It's a great deck. But it's kind of weird to, like I said, to say good game and then to keep playing. Like, what did you mean by that? Like, all you're doing is setting it up to where you good gamed and then won, which was weird, or like, would it look like you were losing, or you just play and the other person's not sure, like, what are they supposed to do, you know? Mm-hmm. Opponent mold to 5. Oof. I'm gonna Elder Fang them nicely here. I can just play the Death Knell, attacks for more. I don't need to play the Disciple. It is better generally to play this later if all else being the same. Mm-hmm. That doesn't sound very pleasant, Wizard Robe. Sounds kind of rude, in fact. Yeah, I'm just going to play this. I don't think I'm supposed to attack. I mean, I could have bluffed something, but like, I feel like they're very likely to block there. G of W Chewy, welcome back to the 313 sub. Good game rope AFK is a nice combo, yeah. So here, let's see. They're foretelling a card. Their deck looks pretty good so far. Ooh. All right, I'm in for this. Because now I can put this on the Death Knell Berserker. And I'm willing to offer the Coma's Faithful trade here. Oh, beating someone who GGs you prematurely is like one of the best feelings. When they're like, they kill your one of your blockers, say GG attack with everything, but then you just like have a trick to barely survive and you turn the game around. Then I GG them back. Look, I'm not going to start things, but I'll finish them. Yeah, their deck looks really good. Three good Snowlands, Avalanche Caller, Behold. But I'll take it. So now their best thing they could have is like a Frostbite or something to kill Koba's Faithful. I guess they could have like Mists of Lit Yara or, well, Wither Crown, sure. I'm going to decline because if I draw a land... Oh. I was going to say, because if I draw a land, I get to Kennel Master and get in for an additional one. Hey, what up, Ark? I guess I'm just going to hit for three and then pass. And then if something dies, like I can Mast Vandal to kill the Wither Crown. I might actually just chump with the Elderfang Disciple if they attack. I don't know how likely do they attack. Probably not going to attack unless they have a blocker, because Elderfang and Avalanche Caller, it's not really good for them to trade hits here. Yeah, Cassandra, there's a lot of Ravenform apologists. I tweeted out like, yeah, Ravenform's pretty bad. And people are like, what? Ravenform's great. I'm going to attack with the Elderfang because I would rather get this Coma's Faithful back here. It's funny. Skemphor Elderhall is great. Like, it makes the deck much better that I have two of them, but I keep drawing them as my fifth land with all five drops in hand. Would I play... I have played Ravenform plenty of times. It is a playable Magic card. It is much, much worse than from what I can tell, the average Arena player thinks. And based on the Twitter responses, maybe just the average Magic player. It's a bad exchange for you. It's bad enough that like you should not want to play it. Ideally, you don't. But I've had decks where it's fine, and I've had situations where it can be good, and situations where it's awful, you know? Oh, what's the current bet, Kep? It's kind of annoying that it doesn't actually show me the Gamblerinos here. What are my top four uncommon lands? Yara, Mirror Lake, Skemphor, Elderhall, I think definitely two of them. Oh, the white-black one as well, the Starnheim Hall or whatever. I think Blood on the Snow. And they get an Avalanche Caller back. Wow, all right. Yeah, their deck's awesome. I think I'm going to do fine here, but their deck's really good. Yikes, Graven Lore into Blood on the Snow. They're just kind of coming back here. You did scam the Hydra pretty badly. Yeah, I don't like the blue-white one at all. It just doesn't fit. Blue-white sucks, first of all. It doesn't fit. Just doesn't fit that neatly into most decks. The red-blue one's fine. Black-red one's not very good. Red-green one's pretty good. It's kind of expensive, the Knotvol Slumber Mound. Green-white one's fine. Red-white one's pretty bad. So, yeah, probably the red-green after the ones I mentioned. Raptor beat the living Cheons out of that Hydra. You guys are very good at focusing. Oh, geez. Skull Raid, too? I mean, I still think the Raven Wings might carry me to victory here, but they're putting in some work. Work, Angelica. Work, Eliza. All right. Demonic Gifts. And it doesn't do much for me here. Let's just give the zombie wings here. I feel like there's a good chance they chump the Grizzled Outrider anyway. So, I mean, I guess I could have gone for the win by putting Raven Wings on the Outrider and attacking with just that. And then if they didn't block, I have Demonic Gifts. But I felt like this was the way. The problem is white-blue is not a good color combination. So it's hard to like make the land work. It just doesn't end up being good. So that... Oh, okay. Okay. Icebreaker Kraken. This is... They're cracking down here. Let's just play the Packmate. Their deck is nice. We kind of scammed them by them mulling to five. I feel like we would have lost badly if they hadn't. I think I'm probably going to win now, but we'll see. If I didn't draw a creature, they could have activated... Let's say if they drew a land, any land, they could have activated three lands and hit me for 21. But yeah, now they can't kill me with all their lands, which is nice. So currently, they could bounce three mana, and then they bounce three snowlands, 3, 7, 9, and there's two snowlands in play. So they can't replay the Kraken this turn. But yeah, they look like just blue-black snow playing snow forest to enable their snow cards, and they have like Skull Raid, Blood on the Snow, Graven Lore, Behold the Multiverse, Avalanche Color, a lot of good ones here. Hey, Spaceship Driver with the 633 months. Welcome back. I appreciate the support. Yeah, take it, I guess. Don't think I need to chump here. They play their last card. I'm going to find out whether or not I can win with just the Raven Wings here. Yeah, I mean, I thought that the Kennel Master was going to be good, but Skull Raid actually got me pretty good. So they need a flyer or they're dead here. They're tapping all their snow. Are they trying to replay the Icebreaker? But that's not even going to work. I just give the Cerulean Packmate wings. Then that's just game. Hey, what's up, Looter Scooter? Shock of Virgo, welcome to the division. Yeah, so they'll have two snowlands in play, and they'll have 5, 9, that's 11 mana for a Kraken, so they're not getting there on the Icebreaker here. Oh, I guess the opponent doesn't know that the Packmate's lethal. Yeah, you're right. I keep forgetting about the demonic grift. Yeah, they can't. I feel like they can't quite do the thing they want to do. Squirrel, the biggest scam was that Globe of Invulnerability, because I finally had something that would answer your stupid mages. All right. Well, there we go. Alrighty, let's continue this mediocre common draft with, oh yeah, we got our bomb here, Raven Wings. Raven Wings is very good. I mean, I joke, but Raven Wings is going to be one of the cards that wins me the most games. So why does blue-white suck in the sick, you ask Hare Krishna? It just happens that the themes in blue and white don't mesh. So the white cards are generally low to the ground aggressive cards. They have like the two spell theme, just the aggressive theme in general. All right, I guess I'll suspend that. And the blue cards are like giants and control cards and snow cards. There's just not a good blue white deck. So I think in general the blue white combination isn't very good. So the blue white land is not very good. Mm-hmm. So the Looter Scooter, I would not take, I would not recommend taking Icebreaker Kraken at any point early. Oh, actually, I guess I should have played the Disciple first, but whatever. Now they know of Vengeful Reaper. Icebreaker Kraken is just not a very good card. It's really hard to use. I mean, my opponent had a really good snow deck, and it's still just not worth the effort. So I would take Shimmer Drift Veil over all, most of the heavy snow payoffs here. Brum, brum. JHN, welcome back with the 2-month resub. I'm not sure about channel points. I'll have to think about that. It's like being a DM in D&D. I gotta decide what my channel points look like. Get the little game designer action going. Wow, our deck's great against mana screwed people who put In Search of Greatness in their deck. We'll be In Search of Greatness in a second as soon as we draft again here. After we rattle off 7 in a row. Yeah, it did. My case did come in, Squirrel. Arc, I'm watching you. Ooh. I'm well acquainted with Naya Feast, and this is some real Naya Feast here. In Search of Greatness is not very good, Molly. I have not found it to be a playable card. And I'm gonna follow it up by killing it. Guardian, Gladewalker, and I think I put this on the Death Knell Berserker. That one's pretty strong in general, and now they're just Omega Dead here. Have I played Dune Imperium yet? A V for a video game. I'm actually in the credits for it. I was one of the people who worked on it, so I have, in fact. I was one of the playtesters. Do. 404 greatness not found. All right, we're 4-0 with this deck. I mean, I had counted on this deck being about a 4-win deck, so deece. I go first. Yeah. I'm gonna keep this hand because it's limited. I'm not gonna mulligan a 4-land 3-spell hand, but yeah, this hand also is In Search of Greatness here. You know what, I'm not the biggest Terry Pratchett fan, Tasty Cactus. Never mind. We drew the Raven Wings game. I've liked some of what Terry Pratchett has written, but in general, it's not my cup of tea, really. I'll trade Demonic Gifts for Finn the Fangbearer here. The Fangbearer is a real clock. The poison part of the card is actually real, so I might as well just use this as a Doomblade right now if I can. Who are some of my favorite authors? Brandon Sanderson, Robert Jordan. Hey, what's up, BK? Not BK. BK's not one of my favorite authors, but he's one of my favorite podcasters. In fact, one of the podcasts I listen to every week involves BK. Trying to think of who's... Scott Lynch, who writes The Lies of Locke Lamora. I like that one. All right. We're both at 20. Coward's Dream. Jim Butcher. I like Jim Butcher. I wouldn't say one of my favorite authors, but he's good. Oh, I like Neal Stephenson quite a bit, though. You misspelled Neil, actually, I think. I think it's Neal, N-E-A-L. But there... I like Peter Hamilton quite a bit. I feel with Doomscar Oracle gaining them life, I don't really want to race there. Oh, this works out nice. Now we get the bear down. Bam. Patrick Rothfuss? No. I liked his books, but the fact that he wrote two books and then isn't writing a third one makes me... Not going to be my favorite author if you can't finish a series. I'm sorry. Yeah, you know, like, I really do like, you know, The Name of the Wind and King Killer's Fear, but, like, you gotta finish him here. It's going to be tough, you know, if you don't. All right, let's play the Packmate first and see if we can draw a land here. We didn't. We're at 18, they're at 20. I actually still think attacking here is fine. Yeah, but I think the difference is that the Lies of Locke Lamora and the Gentleman Bastards trilogy and stuff they all feel like fairly complete books, whereas King Killer's Fear definitely does not. Like, it leaves off as definitely part of the series. I really wanted more from it. I just didn't quite get there. Ooh, that's rough. Okay. We might need to pump the brakes a little bit here. Now, I'm probably going to give some wings here. I wish I liked Malazan Book of the Fallen so I could tell people who recommend it that I read it and liked it, because so many people recommend it, and I just got to tell them all that I tried reading it, did not like it. I don't know, just not for me. I put it on the Packmate here. I think this is better, because I'm just worried that if I put it on the Outrider and then they kill or like bound and silence the Outrider, I just take a huge hit. Now I'm willing to make some trades here. Whoa, thanks for the raid, Cordo Calls. Thanks everyone from Alex's stream here. All right, I'll block there. Yeah, I'm fine to just start trading off. I have a lot more crappy creatures where that came from. We're getting some wings here. Raven Wings is doing its job. What do I do? I have 6 mana. Oh yeah, this baby is going to fit lots of garbage creatures in it. That's for sure. 15 or 12. China Miéville is an incredible author. I really love China Miéville. That's actually one of my favorite authors for sure. So now I've got basically like 3-ish different plays. Well, first of all, I can play 3 different cards here. I think I'm going to play the Elderleaf Mentor and then put wings on this one, so they can't attack with their Starnheim Courser without making a trade here. And then I'm fine trading Grizzled Outrider. Actually, if they attack with the Outrider, I might block with Mentor plus Disciple, getting even more nice equipment value here. I've read pretty much all of John Scalzi's books. His books are good. Not my favorite, but they're good. They're worth reading. I find Brent Weeks' series like Black Prism and Lightbringer to just be okay. Again, I've read a lot of books, and I'm willing to read books that aren't, they don't all have to be the best. So now what is this they're hiding down there? Is it an Iron Verdict? Kind of feels like that might be. Is it time to start the grind, get on the grind here? Oh, I like the Farseer series. Yeah, I like Robin Hobb. Let's go. You know what? I'm okay. I guess I'm okay if they have Iron Verdict here. I'm going to attack with these two and then put the wings on the 1-1 if they just take it. I also grew up on like some of the old like Raymond E. Feist books and stuff like that, and I like them. I haven't felt compelled to reread them or anything, but I like them. I've read just basically a ton of like fantasy and sci-fi books. Those are my favorite books in general. Like Dune is the best. I don't read as much as I used to, though I am reading a book right now, but like I read books really fast, and a not so shocking twist. Oh, so they drew a trick. Okay. So one of the things you can do when they make an attack where you think they have a trick is you can line up multiple blocks you consider favorable, and then even if they have a trick, it's just not as bad for you. Like here, I think I just put this on Courser. And I think I just put this on the Troll and then this on the Fin. Actually, I don't even need to block Fin. I'm taking 6. I guess I die to Kaya's Outrage or whatever, regardless. I guess if I cared about that, I could put the Grizzled Outrider there, this on Fin, and then I don't die. My hand is pretty good. Let's just do it this way. Oh, they just didn't have anything? Okay, I mean, I'm not unhappy with those trades. I guess they attacking with the Old Growth Troll is kind of a free roll, because if it dies, they just get the thing back. Is the idea, maybe? I don't know. Put the wings on the Disciple and then pass. I have read a decent amount of the Bible, Squirrel. I went to Catholic high school. Fall of the Impostre. Okay. Elder Hall is not bad. I'm at 5. Let's go. wings on the Outrider. Attack for six in the air, and then I play Coma's Faithful. Put the wings on the Coma's Faithful and play the Elder Hall. And now, if they put another counter on the Courser, I can just trade. If they put a counter on the Troll, I can trade with the Courser and then attack them back for lethal. I mean, if they draw something, this is going to be close. I do have the Elder Hall as well. Oh no, they draw a fight card. Oh, another Finn. Okay, then they're going to pass. Right now, that's going to eat my Grizzle Outrider. They're at seven. I can't force them to chump by using Elder Hall. But if I use Elder Hall, let's see, I have four, seven, eight. I still can... okay, I can still re-equip the wings. So the question is, would I rather attack with... I guess if I attack with the Coma's Faithful and they trade and then they exile this, but if I attack, put wings on this and attack, then they exile it, but I keep the Coma's Faithful alive. All right, let's put the wings on this. Send. And if they go to one, I can make two tokens. Okay, so they're going to do this. Yeah, this is fine then. I think it's worth just using the Elder Hall, even though I'm not getting anything but two tokens out of it. Seems fine to me. They exile my bear. They can attack me, but I probably... block the troll with just a 1-1, because then I start using Coma's Faithful with lifelink to race the troll. Spectral Steel. Oh, I don't think that's actually the one they wanted to put it on. Well, I don't know. This is close. This is going to end up being a really close game. They should attack with both. I'm just going to block. Go to 1 here. And then draw. Oh. That has to kill them, right? Because now I can put wings on this, attack, and then name elf. Or I guess I don't have to name anything. They just, boom, toast. Do I miss the good old days of the Pro Tour now that they've gone different? Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Organized play has not been what I would have chosen over the past now 3 years, is a way to say it. Early candidates for Mythic Uncommon of the set? I'm not sure. There's a lot of really good uncommons in the set for sure. No, I don't think that's the case, Dark Brew. I think that the changes were not driven by budget because they spent plenty of money on it. Though at some point they did take a bunch out, and maybe that is a budget concern. But it's just the direction, I think. I don't know. I think the MPL was the beginning of the end for a lot of the things I liked about organized play. Though I do really like Rivals League play. I thought League play is a really cool system. That's something that was like a meaningful improvement. That's like the first thing I thought was really good here. Avalanche Caller is very high up there, yeah. Oh, yeah. Here we go. Yeah, there's no Zenith Flare, no Roost of Drakes, nothing quite like that. There we go. Look at all these medium commons. We're doing it. Oh man, yeah, Helene leaving was a real shame. Helene was awesome. Helene was the best. Yep, Molly. Slaps roof of deck. This baby can fit so many replacement level commons in it. Their deck's already better than mine. Look at that. They have a snow-covered island. Alright. Just play my 2-2. Yeah, I mean, Binding the Old Gods is good, but, like, it's still just a removal spell. Like, it's not unbeatable. Now, if you have it with some Master Scalds, then you got a stew going, but when I hear Mythic Uncommon, Avalanche Caller is, like, pretty close to that. That card represents so much damage. Janice, welcome back to the 41-month resub. How's it going? Just play an Elderfang Disciple. Whatever. Tab C with the 25 months. Welcome back. Yeah, I mean, Svella's very good. I love Svella. I think she's one of the best uncommons as well. But again, not when I think of like a mythic level uncommon, I think of Zenith Flare or Roost of Drakes or something that's like gonna be unbeatable in a lot of games. Do I make my own pasta sauce? I certainly have. All my cards are bad. I'm willing to trade them off. Oh no, what'll I do if they have a combat trick? Yeah, like Shepherd of the Cosmos is great, but yeah, I'm not gonna call it unbeatable. What can the, what am I gonna do? Get back two feasters. That's what I'm gonna do. Oh yeah, we're really grinding them out here with our Elderfang disciples. I'm gonna wait on the Gladewalker because I think at this point I'd rather put the counter somewhere else here. I'm glad you like the blue red deck, Stampfler. Saying you have four sideboard slots left is not really giving me enough information, but I have, I do think that I like the escape package of creatures in the deck if you don't have that. Ox of Agonis and Phoenix of Ash. I see you, Eric. I see you. Oh yeah, look at Grizzled Outrider getting in there. I Binky Brown, I didn't upload any Supreme drafts because I don't anticipate ever doing another one. I didn't find them fun at all. I even tried. I tried one of the vintage ones. I tried one of the earlier ones. Definitely not a format I enjoy. Yeah, what Molly said. Ooh, this is gonna work out nicely. They're gonna bind the monster, and I'm gonna unbind the monster. In fact, I'm gonna chump here because I want to be able to unbind the monster right now. Ooh, yeah. I could play Cerberus Packmate to try to draw a land, but like, I could also just unbind the monster and play Coma's Faithful, and I think that's going to be good enough. I really need to draw my Sword of Fire and Ice, Raven Wings. I like this format. I think this is like probably like an above average format, you know? Not the best, definitely not the worst. Not all podcast co-hosts love the format, but I think it's good. Hey, what's up, Caddy Six? Hey, you know what? I appreciate that. It's very kind words. I like that you enjoy what I do here. Speaking of Burgi, the god of storytelling. Oh. What can I do here? I've got a couple options. I could Guardian Gladewalker to Coma's Faithful to kind of force a trade there. And I guess I could then make an Elven Bow. I could also bow. I do kind of want a bow plus Rune of Mortality. I could also Cerulean's Packmate first to try to draw a land, but I think that getting the attack in this turn is probably what I want to do. I guess they could double block my bear, but then I just kill Burgi, and that's fine with me too. She's a card, especially when they're stuck on four lands, that can give them access to a lot of plays here. Play Elven Bow, and I at this point I think. Do I want to make the creature and the next turn I can play and equip? Yeah, that's probably fine. Hey, Scott is not aware. Thanks for gifting some subs. I appreciate that. Okay, there's Svella Ice Shaper. See, like, I mean, obviously they're a little behind the eight ball here, but Svella isn't gonna like defeat me here. I guess she's not the best under pressure still. It's a good card. It's not unbeatable, you know. I've talked about all the different draft formats and rated them at various times, but I guess I don't know if I've done a dedicated stream of just doing that. All right, now that we have a Death Touch +1/+2 weapon, we're gonna grind them out. If they weren't mana screwed, this would give us a lot of staying power. The fact that they are is something. Are we gonna 7-0 with this deck? Oh man, yes we are, because Kennel Master was a draw. Definitely the Packmate, and probably at that point the Gladewalker. And then send. And if they want to double block my Masked Vandal to kill it, they can take 8 for their trouble. Well, we're 5-0 now, but we're about to be 6-0 after we win here. Yes, this set did trade flavor text for rules text, but I enjoy this set. I think it's got some fun stuff going on. I think Khans of Tarkir is quite high. Like if I were to, it's hard for me to know what are we blocking. They are double blocking the Masked Vandal. Okay. I'm into that. Like, if I were to think of, like, what my top five draft formats are, I don't know. I always, like, I don't have a hard and fast list. I always talk about Khans, Dominaria, Innistrad. I really like Mirrodin, Mirrodin, Darksteel a lot. Those tend to be the ones. AVR and Ixalan are both horrendous, for sure. 6-0, no big deal. Ryze was very good. Yeah, I like Ryze. Basically, I kind of think of draft formats in a couple tiers. There's like the F tier ones. Ooh, tier lists. With Avacyn Restored and Ixalan. I think those are just horrendous. And then there's like the S tier ones like Dominaria and Innistrad and Khans. I think are all just perfection. And then there's like Ryze, which I think is like A tier. And Mirrodin, Mirrodin, Darksteel, if I'm being true to myself, is probably like A tier, not S tier. And same with Champions. I like Champions, and that's probably like a B, A or B tier, something like that. I thought SOI draft was quite good. That would probably be like a B or B tier draft for me. RTR, I have RTR like B or C tier. Original Ravnica, I think, is probably the biggest delta between its people's perception and where I have it. Oh, I think Invasion draft is A tier, actually. And I've gone back and forth because the mana really isn't good in Invasion Draft, but Invasion Draft has such fun cards. I don't know. When they brought back Invasion Draft for a week on Magic Online, I did like 30 drafts. So based on that, I have to just upgrade it for myself here, you know. This hand does not look good enough to win. So it's like all my other hands that I'm going to keep and potentially get there. Triple Theros, solid like B to C tier. Ark, you would like IPA. No one's going to know about you. You're someone who like IPAs and IPA. I thought Odyssey was kind of mediocre. Like, cards were so bad in Odyssey. If you enjoy playing 18 playables, three unplayables and 19 land a lot, Odyssey is the format for you, you know? Modern Horizons is fine. I never really loved Modern Horizons. All the core set drafts are basically somewhere between like C and B for me. Sometimes D, like core sets, I get what they're trying to do so they don't lose points by not being more complex, but the fact they're not more complex means I just don't enjoy them that much. Bum, bum, bum. Masked Vandal has been obscene for me in this deck. Squirrel, that's many formats, yeah. I think it is IPA, the one you're talking about, but Shadowmoor Eventide is one of the worst draft formats, yeah. I think that... Oh, I guess Lorwyn's actually worse, but they're all pretty bad. What was the most fun core set? Probably, like, one of the really modern ones, like M20 or whatever. I think M20 was very good. Mass Vandal is probably going to be good against Red-White, is my guess. Origins was okay. Origins was really disappointing. I always remember, I'm still bitter about the fact that Origins had a lot of build arounds and just never, and it was never good enough. Yeah, let's vandalize this. That didn't take long, did it? The fact that my thing has lifelink means I'd rather just get in there, get my three. Ikoria was fine. The cycling stuff was too much. That it was fun, a fun like sideshow, but it was a bit much, I think. Oh man, they're just flooded with good targets. Okay, I guess I'll. They're getting a treasure, but if they don't have a play here, Coma's Faithful is going to be pretty nice. Oh, there we go. Yeah, let's get in there. I also feel like Kennel Master is going to be nice here because I'll just take my extra guaranteed 2 extra damage here plus with lifelink, and then it can block the Doomscar Oracle, and Blizzard Brawl still, I think, probably going to land here even without the Kennel Master to help it. Gorilla Gregory with a 5-month resub. Welcome back. It's also like them getting a treasure. It's not like they're getting a Lotus Petal. It's not the end of the world, you know? Okay. They're racing a lifelinker here, which, I mean, they're getting two a turn, I guess, but still racing a lifelinker here. Okay, let's see. Yeah, now the Demon Bolt has actually made this a little tough. I can't even use the Elder Hall. Let's play this and let's nug them, I think. And then pass. I'll wait on the Blizzard Brawl. I think I can find a better spot here. I think the overall structure of Limited is better now. Like, I would say the average set, I have higher expectations now because they've discovered some stuff. The London Mulligan's very good for Limited. They're much more aggressive about playing, putting stuff like Fortel or Cycling or what have you. Oh, Raise the Draugr is going to be really good here, isn't it? Because I want to get that Masked Vandal to kill that Raven Wings. So if I attack, they'll block Coma's Faithful on the 2-1. I think I just do this and then use Blizzard Brawl after combat. Like, I'm hoping they just block Masked Vandal there. Oh, they just took it like that. All right. That's fine. And then I get to mill 3. Oh, no, I didn't mill any creatures. That's fine, though, because now I can go Blizzard Brawl. Well, how badly do I want this? I was really hoping the Masked Vandal got eaten. There's 7. I could Blizzard Brawl. I think I have to cast Raise the Draugr here. So the question is it worth throwing away a Blizzard Brawl to do that? I think so. Yeah, I know it's an instant, but if I don't do this here, then I can get one creature back, and that's pretty bad. These don't share a type. I think I still just do this. So I can raise the Masked Vandal and the Kennel Master. And then vandalize the Raven Wings here. It would be nice to be able to vandalize the pick and kill their thing. I think I still kill the... Actually, you know what? I might kill the pick. Never mind. I'm going to kill the Gold Vein pick. I hope I don't end up regretting that. But I'm on such the aggressive that I think I'd rather do that. Now I need to draw Swamp. Having all forests is kind of rough with this Elder Hall here. But yeah, so the average limited set has gotten much better. They're just doing a lot. Oh, geez. That's going to be tough. Oreo Weaver, welcome back. Oh no, yeah, that's good. Okay. I mean, this basically it's very good, but it's not necessarily game over. I've got some stuff. So anyway, the average limited set is just going to be a lot better now. I think I have a pretty high expectation of most limited sets these days. Ooh. Interessante. So what am I going to do here? If I make this into a 3-5 indestructible, I can attack. I could also... I'm just going to play this and pass, I think. And then next turn, I can Kennel Master those two and get a good attack in. Okay, 2-2. Not a lot of text. I guess it means that when the Marshal dies, it can exile the Berserker and give these two another counter. Yeah. Oh, they have one card in hand? How likely is it it's just a land? Well, if I make this a 3-5 indestructible and this a 3-3 indestructible, they're in a spot where they take it and they have to, or just do some chumps. Yeah, let's just do that. That's fine. Kennel Master really giving them the business here. Hey, I'm glad you like it. A Pulse 4. Yeah, I think that the Izzet list is quite good. All right, so they're gonna lose the Resplendent Marshal here. I mean, if they're double chumping, I'm really into that, because that's just gonna make it really hard for them to win future games here. Bum bum. So now they're going to make this into a 4-3 and a 4-3, but okay, we'll see. if their hand is a spell and they draw another spell, they might not be able to play both, so the Disciple's good. If their hand is a land, it doesn't matter whether I used it too much. Okay. Oh, it's not a land, I don't think, so... Oh, but now I drew the swamp for Skim for Elder Hall. So if I Elder Hall... I'm just going to Disciple. It feels like this actually is going to get something here. Oh, never mind. All right, land. And no attacks. You don't really want to trade off when they have an equipped creature, because that's just trading down a little bit. Okay. Yeah, I got like a little debated there. Oh, Demonic Gifts. Okay, that's going to be really good. If I can get this Masked Vandal to die. So what happens if I attack with everything? Kennel Master gets blocked by like this. They double block the Skimfar Shadow Mage. And then they take two going to five. But if I Demonic Gifts the Shadow Mage, it then comes back and drains them for four? Cleric, 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 cleric. Or they block Shadow Mage there and eat like the Disciple. And then I can make the Disciple bigger. I also have the Elder Hall, so I might be able to post combat Elder Hall. Yeah, I think this actually is going to be fine. Math is not for blockers. I think that's one of the statements that doesn't make that much sense. I know it's a funny statement, but math is like, it's actually more for attackers. Oh, they're just blocking that. So I could use Demonic Gifts to take them down to one. They really don't want to get Elder Hauled here, I guess, is the idea. Sure, I could also, would I rather have a Kennel Master here than a Demonic Gifts, but without the trigger? Yeah, I probably would. All right, well, there we go. Ooh, seven wins. Did not expect this deck to A, get seven wins, B, go 7-0. that worked out pretty nicely. This video, along with all the ones I make here, is sponsored by Ultimate Guard. Ultimate Guard is a proud sponsor of Team Channel Fireball, and it's been awesome to work with them. Look at that. Look at all those shiny gems. You go to ultimateguard.com, take a look at their awesome sleeves, boxes, accessories, all that stuff. And, hopefully next video we get to hit 7-0 quite so easily. We'll see.